कैनफ सुरेश गुडे।
हाँ सुरेश गुडे सर।
ये बिलोंग टू विच प्लेस?
आंध्र प्रदेश सर। आंध्र प्रदेश सर।
अच्छा ओके गुड वेरी नाइस।
कैन आई स्टार्ट सर?
या आस्क अदर सर दैट आई डोंट नो आई एम रेडी।
जितेश कुमार वर्किंग एज शॉपकीपर बिलोंग्स टू लोअर सोशियो इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस फ्रॉम नवाडा डिस्ट्रिक्ट ब्रॉट विद चीफ कंप्लेंट्स ऑफ shortness of breath since 10 years and palpitations since 5 years. My patient is apparently all right 10 years back when he developed shortness of breath on exertion, initially on heavy work and climbing two stairs and walking for 500 meters to this shop, which is of grade NVHA class 1, which is insidious in onset, gradually progressed to shortness of breath present even during routine daily activities and climbing one stairs of NVHA class over 5 years. Shortness of breath present during rest and apnea and paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea aggravated by the lying down position and exertion, really rest without fever and without any seasonal variation 5 years back, for which he was admitted in hospital, relieved after some IV injections, which
Suresh
increases urine output.
Suresh, are you there? Suresh, hello, Suresh. Suresh, are you able to hear me? Bhushan, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, that gentleman not able to hear me. Suresh.
I think he lost connection. I will just connect again.
Sorry, sir. Disconnect ho gaya sir. Beech mein.
Okay, bolo. Can you repeat that your last two sentences? Repeat.
Okay, sir. History of apnea and paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea, aggravated by the lying position and exertion, relieved by the rest. Without any extra fever, cough, and expectoration, and seasonal variation, for which admitted at hospital 5 years back.
Okay, stay there. You are telling that he has history of PND and orthopnea, no? He has history of PND and aggravated by exertion. What aggravated by PND or orthopnea? Aggravated by exertion, relieved by rest. What does it mean? This sentence has no meaning. He has got history of PND and orthopnea. Aggravated by exertion and
relieved by sitting up position, sir. Matlab, I want to tell you, this is the exertional dyspnea related to the cardiac region, sir.
Arey bhaiya, you told, no? He has orthopnea aggravated by exertion. Orthopnea aggravated by exertion. What is orthopnea to me? Let's go to a little bit cross question. What is orthopnea?
Orthopnea is dyspnea present on the lying down position, sir.
Why does it happen?
It happens due to the increased venous return during the lying down position that leads to the pulmonary edema, and there is also a movement of the diaphragm that leads to the decreased compliance of the lung that leads to the apnea, sir.
Pulmonary edema. Achha, what pulmonary edema? Okay, fine. So why does it happen? One is diaphragm goes up, okay. So second what happens? Blood come.
Increased venous return that leads to the increased cardiac venous return to the heart, but already dysfunctional left ventricle is unable to pump the extra amount of the blood that is received. That leads to the pulmonary edema.
Pulmonary edema. Okay, fine. So that is orthopnea.
Yes.
Okay, fine. So So then not to your sentence not correct now. It would agree to exertion orthopnea. Orthopnea, he had histopenia, orthopnea pain is don't mention he had histopenia orthopnea. I really by I'm sitting up question. Not required. This
okay, sir.
History of PND orthopnea.
Okay, sir. History of 2 to 3 similar episodes per year. Last episode is 5 days back, sir, for which he was admitted in hospital. These episodes are associated with the palpitations in the form of increased rate of contraction, irregular in character, which are of sudden onset and sudden termination spontaneously sometimes and sometimes relieved by medications after admission to the hospital and not associated with any post palpitation diuresis and syncope.
Now, what is palpitation due to?
He's saying increased rate of contraction, sir, and irregular and intermittent sudden onset.
Sorry, Suresh, listen. How can he say that increased rate of contraction?
Heart is beating very rapid. He is saying rapid beating of the heart, sir.
Okay, rapid beating heart or increase heart rate. Can heart contraction tell increase rate of contraction? Use good words. So there is it is coming all and sudden.
All of a sudden, sir.
It is abrupt onset. Abrupt in onset, abrupt onset also. So abrupt onset, abrupt onset. Or sometimes he relieves palpitation after admission, taking some medication.
Yes, sir.
So what do you think from history, what could be the cause of palpitation here?
Most common cause of increased rate of contraction is sinus tachycardia, sir. But here it is sudden onset and sudden termination, sir. So it is not possible, sir. Sinus tachycardia will be gradual onset and gradual offset, sir.
That may know, yeah. What is here happening? Tell me.
Paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, sir. That can be sudden onset and sudden offset, sir. And ventricular tachycardia, sir, non-sustained ventricular tachycardia. That may be also sudden onset and sudden offset, sir.
Non-sustained.
Ventricular tachycardia of less than 30 milliseconds duration.
Millisecond? 30 milliseconds?
30 seconds duration. 30 second duration.
So the patient level 20 seconds and you shocked him. So what kind of tachycardia it is? 20 seconds. And you shock the patient.
If we intervene because of the instability, that is will be characterized as a sustained tachycardia, sir, because it is we don't know how much.
Then why not including the patient then? So you mean the patient has got
without any intervention.
Example asked you what is the possible cause of arrhythmia palpitation here. You will say arrhythmia palpitation, the most poorly it is upper onset, upper onset, maybe SVT or VT, you mean? As
yes.
VT or SVT? Okay. Either SVT or VT. You told me atrial fibrillation.
Paroxysmal atrial fibrillation.
Why?
I don't know if I want to say. It also for sudden onset. Confirmly, we can't say, sir. Maybe because it may be a sweet error, because there is a chances of I'm suspecting some rheumatic heart disease associated mostly with the atrial fibrillation. That's why I have included, sir. Maybe it may be also a sweet error, so possible, sir.
Okay, sir.
And
paroxysmal atrial fibrillation. What is paroxysmal AFib? How to define that?
Yeah.
The definition of paroxysmal atrial fibrillation.
It will be of less than 24 hours duration, sir. It will be not sustained, sir. spontaneous 10 minutes.
Okay. Usual 24 hours, less than 24 hours. But commonly, at what definition is how much? What duration? Maximum duration? You just tell me. Is classified yes. The accumulation on temporal basis.
If it is more than 7 days, it is called.
More than.
More than seven.
No, you are not confident. You are not very confident. You tell.
Yes.
7. If 50% 7 are coming, and 50% remaining in your mouth.
Okay, sir. Assistant atrial.
You classify the atrial fibrillation depending upon duration. On temporal pattern, you classify the atrial fibrillation.
Okay, sir. If it is more than 1 year duration, it is persistent atrial fibrillation, sir. If it is more than 24 hours, it is chronic atrial fibrillation.
Why you got this definition?
I forgot the definition, duration ideally.
Attribution definition, you should not forget at all. What is permanent attribution? What is your understanding of permanent attribution? Permanent, permanent attribution. What do you mean permanent attribution?
It is persisting even with the treatments, sir. Not able to subside.
You read this today.
Hardly. Okay.
You read today. If you get chance, ask you tomorrow. I'm ask you this.
Okay. Sir.
One day after tomorrow. Tomorrow Sunday. Day after tomorrow. I'll ask you this. You read. Attribution is one full. Day to day, you read attribution. And attribution has come very recent. Let's come or Jack of the read attribution.
Okay. Sir.
Okay, so here I am giving you a from his double
attribution. SVT, sir, maybe SVT attribution, sir.
What type of SVT you know?
SVT, it may be due to AV nodal reentry tachycardia, sir, and AV and arthrodromic reentry tachycardia, sir, AVRT.
Okay.
And atrial supraventricular tachycardia, maybe atrial flutter, also atrial flutter and multifocal atrial tachycardias. All these are supraventricular tachycardias.
Okay. Fine. Okay, so you are thinking of addressing that could be paroxysmal nature.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay, then you admitted your hospital with these symptoms.
Yes, sir.
Then what else? He had got some breath palpitations. Then. And that is five years history of palpitation, yeah?
Well, intermittent, sir. These are intermittent nature with 2 to 3 episodes per year. Intermittently, they are...
You lost Matla when you speak, I think, Bihar, no? Bihar, Patna. But Telugu people, they don't say Matla. Matla means he is born in Bihar, I think, Matla. And the Matla, 5 years, what is that? The intermittent, every, all 5 years having intermittent arrhythmia.
Yes, sir.
Matlab, we are getting this. For last 5 years, we are getting this person getting. Okay, fine. Last 5 years, not developed persistent atrial fibrillation. Still having atrial fibrillation of paroxysmal nature. Okay, it may happen also.
Sure.
Okay, fine. Go ahead.
Okay. And there is no history of chest. Yes, sir. No history of chest pains. Syncope and fatigue and ectasis. No history of nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain and edema. No history of hemoptysis and hoarseness of voice. No history of prolonged fever and skin rash. At the age of 8 years,
this boy developed chest angina, typical angina. What do you possibly think of? This boy developed typical angina pectoris. What are the possibilities? 20-year boy. Having angina CTP, having breathlessness yes. For last 10 years and for just 5 years and angina there.
It may be due to the if it is associated with the mitral stenosis and right ventricular hypertrophy, that may lead to the demand, supply demand mismatch and ischemia, sir. second region is if it is mitral stenosis associated with the aortic stenosis, that may lead to the angina, sir, because of the left ventricular subduramen ischemia. Other condition is if it is atrial fibrillation, that may lead to the embolization very rarely, and that may lead to the ischemia, sir.
But that will develop, what? That will develop time to MI.
Yes, sir.
Not angina injury, that develop because acute obstruction of the coronary artery develop mitral impaction. Could be non-sustained, sorry, could be STEMI, could be non-STEMI. What angina, stable angina pectoris with the coronary embolism is not a feature.
Okay, sir.
Okay, fine. Forget that. 20-liter man has bias come to typical angina pectoris. What are the possibilities? No other history, only angina.
Bicuspid aortic wall with aortic stenosis, sir.
Yes, sir.
And atherosclerotic heart disease is also presentation, sir. And tacheus wateritis, sir. That leads to coronary artery involvement. And hypertrophic obstructive cardiomyopathy, that may lead to the demand mismatch, sir.
Okay, you told that. Okay. You told arthritis, could you take issue some of the arthritis? You told aortic stenosis, optical endomyopathy. Possible, okay, fine. Any sort of animal you can think of also?
Actually, alkapas may present, sir, but these they present very early, around childhood. They present in childhood, sir.
So no, matlab alkapas not only coronary anomaly, so many other animals there.
Yes, there are other animals
with coronary anomaly. And dangerous coronary anomaly, which the patient may have sudden cardiac death.
Yes.
Particular, tell you one dangerous cardiac, dangerous, very dangerous coronary anomaly. Patient has to suppose you patient has symptoms on effort there are angina pectoris and you did angiogram and you immediately you have to send for surgery. Dangerous for the other patient may have sudden death anytime on a heavy exertion. I'm not thinking of alcapalia. 23 man storm with stable angina on effort. And you did angiogram, you got coronary anomaly and you have sent immediate for surgery. So no, that they will ask, no, you examination, you don't expect question from your case. So you may be asked different questions. We have to assess your knowledge, how much you have acquired during the last 3 years. So coronary artery going through both out and coronary artery, no? Coronary anomaly is going, coronary artery is left coronary artery mostly going through, even right coronary artery also, right going through out and coronary artery. So during exertion, coronary is compressed because hemodynamic, hemodynamic cause. So
this one is a disconnect, okay, sir.
No, CT scan, CT scan, CT scan, MRI. Then sent for surgery. Okay, so history over? History over? Any important
history? At the age of 8 years. Yes, sir.
At the age of 8 years.
Patient had the history of fever with fleeting joint pains involving the knee and ankle, after which some white colored injections advised by the local doctor. For every 21 days, and he is compliance with the treatment, sir. He had the at the age of 8 years, patient had the history of fever.
He has history of acute rheumatic fever.
Yes, sir.
He has the history of acute rheumatic fever at the age of 8 years.
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Finish, then what happened? taking prophylaxis.
Yes, sir. He is taking prophylaxis.
Then.
And he had fever with weakness of the right lower limb, which persisted and diagnosed as the polio at the age of. And there is no history of hypertension, type 2 diabetes mellitus, jaundice, no history of previous surgeries and blood transfusion, no history of drug allergy, no history of similar complaints in the family, and taking mixed diet, non-smoker and non-alcohol, bowel and bladder habits are normal, and sleep is disturbed since last 5 days, and appetite is decreased, belongs to lower socioeconomic status, and overcrowding is present. And summarizing, 28-year-old male patient with history of acute rheumatic fever at the age of 8 years, with regular benzathine penicillin prophylaxis, with insidious onset dyspnea, which gradually progressed to NYHA class 1 to NYHA class 4 over 5 years, associated with intermittent, irregular, sudden onset and offset palpitations. Most probably my diagnosis is rheumatic heart disease with left-sided stenotic lesion, most probably mitral stenosis associated with the paroxysmal atrial fibrillation.
Okay.
And second probable diagnosis is atrial septal defect, sir. But here in atrial septal defect, PND is not possible, sir. So it is excluded, sir. And third probable diagnosis, dilated cardiomyopathy with ventricular tachycardia. But it will have very rapid progression, sir, dilated cardiomyopathy. Such a long history not possible, sir.
Then any fourth?
Yes, sir.
Fourth?
Hello?
Fourth, sir. You can tell you the third defense rights. Why do you bring a testicular defect here? He's a 28-year man. I mean, he's certainly better for the last 10 years and a participant in 5 years. Why do you bring here a testicular defect? Nothing to know. He has got orthopnea, PND, so many things are there. So, the only thing matters is here.
Mitral stenosis is more common in the females, sir. It is not mitral regurgitation.
Why not the case of mitral regurgitation? Why do you think of mitral stenosis?
Because it is a very, there is a long duration of history, such 10 years, and there is associated with the, there are no, the history of fatigue and exertion, which may be present with the mitral regurgitation. And there are no history of any palpitations, sir.
Yeah? There is no palpitation there.
Hello. No. He's saying that the palpitation character is a sudden onset, sir. With mitral regurgitation, they will be gradual onset and offset, sir.
MR patient can develop atrial fibrillation. Okay, because of long duration patient of breathlessness, we are not thinking of MR. We think of mitral stenosis.
If a MR patient would have developed orthopnea and PND, it will be mostly acute MR, otherwise chronic MR with left ventricular failure, sir.
No, I know this, that chronic MR failure is not possible. Here. 10 years history chronic MR. Ronnie came. Which condition get acute MR orthopnea? What are the conditions? Patient acute MR and orthopnea. What are the conditions you get? Tell me causes of acute MR.
Acute MR is more post ischemic, sir. With post ischemic caudal rupture, that may lead to the acute MR, sir. And other causes are infective endocarditis, that may lead to the acute MR.
Yeah. Yeah.
And any iatrogenic cells during the balloon metal valvectomy, if they reach a rupture of the cord, cusp, that may lead to the acute MR, sir. Caudal rupture or comes. Then he will have PND and orthopnea, sir. But chronic MR, if there is that long duration, mostly it is of left ventricular failures.
Will it be PND orthopnea and acute MR? Will it be PND?
Mostly it is the most orthopnea, sir, because it is a rapid progression. There may be that not that much time for the PND to develop, sir. It may be suddenly progress to orthopnea, sir.
According
to rheumatic fever prevalence also, MS is most common, sir. That's why I'm not expecting MS, sir.
No, you can't say most common or least common. That is not the thing. Yeah.
Yes.
You can't go by all the time most common, least common. After all, environment, it could be MR, it could be MS. So tell me, so that's why my question there is question coming. What is the natural history of asymptomatic MR, symptomatic MR? Just to know that. Asymptomatic MR, yes. MR there?
With symptomatic MR, a 10-year mortality rate is around 40%, sir. 40% sir, 10-year mortality rate.
No, 60% survival, sir.
Yes, 60% survival,
sir.
Yeah, but here palpitations are sudden onset and suddenly terminated by the drug treatment, sir. That is not possible with the acute MR, sir. MR, the palpitations are only gradual onset, sir. Gradual onset and gradually terminate if there are any palpitations. And there is also history of fatigue and exertion, sir. That is also not there.
Atopism won't develop if
you
have symptomatic MR,
sir. AF can develop, sir, in atrial fibrillations with MR, sir.
You are thinking that MR and atrial fibrillation will
develop, sir. MR with atrial fibrillation.
Develop.
MR atrial fibrillation will develop, sir, because there is a electrical enlargement, there will be problems. But long duration only I am suspecting of mitral stenosis because of the long duration.
Okay.
Sure.
Other halls not possible. Outer wall not possible. Outer wall ACR not possible. Only mitral stenosis. You got rheumatic fever and you got mitral stenosis. Okay.
Yes. And general examination. Patient is conscious on general examination, sir.
Good.
Patient is conscious and coherent, both time, place, person, moderately built and moderately nourished, pulse rate of 78 per minute, regular, decreased volume, with no radio-radial and no radio-femoral delay, all peripheral pulses are well-fed, with normal vessel character. Blood pressure, right upper limb is 100 by 80, and left upper limb is 100 by 70 and left lower limb is 120 by 70 in supine position. Respiratory rate is 24 per minute, abdominal thoracic, AFib breath, with a BMI of 21.5 kg meter square and no palar ecterus sinusis clumping, no lymphadenopathy and no beta lida. Oral cavity examination is normal, spine examination is normal and there is atrophy of the right lower limb on examination and there is no signs of infective endocarditis and aortic regurgitation. JDP 4 cm above the stem.
What are the signs of endocarditis? There is no signs of endocarditis. What are the signs of endocarditis?
Skin manifestation, there will be petechias, sir. There are immunological manifestations. There are vascular phenomena, sir. Vascular phenomena include the subconjunctival hemorrhage and immunological phenomena includes the oscillators, nodes. Vascular phenomena, John Wayne lesion is also there, sir, in present on the palms.
JVP
4 cm above the sternal angle at 45 degrees of normal height with prominent A wave. Seen no abdominal jugular reflex and no Kussmaul sign and no venous summit present. On inspection, chest is bilaterally symmetrical without any precordial bulge. Apex seen at 5th intercostal space, lateral 1 cm lateral to the midclavicular. No scars and sinuses and dilated veins. Visible epigastric pulsations are present and visible suprasternal pulsations are present. On palpation, inspector findings are confirmed. Apex at 5th intercostal space, 1 cm lateral to the midclavicular line, diffuse in character with lateral retraction and RV type. Palpable P2 is present, parasternal heave of grade 2 by 3 is present, epigastric pulsations are palpable and suprasternal pulsations are present and no associated thrill. And percussion, left heart border corresponds to the left apex and right heart border below the sternum. Left second intercostal space is dull and liver dullness felt at the 5th intercostal space on the right side. And auscultation, S1 is loud, S2 is narrow split with a loud P2 component, no S3 is present, S4 is present, opening snap is present with wide A2 and opening snap interval and there is no ejection click present. Mid-diastolic murmur of rough and rumbling character present at the apex of grade 3 by 4 localized with pre-systolic accentuation with bell of the stethoscope in left lateral position, best heard during the expiration. Ejection systolic murmur of grade 3 by 6 at right second intercostal space, harsh quality and late peaking murmur with crescendo decrescendo character radiating to the carotids with diaphragm of the stethoscope in leaning forward position, best during the expiration. And early diastolic murmur of grade 2 by 4 present in the third left intercostal space, which is of decrescendo character of shorter duration with diaphragm of the stethoscope in leaning forward position, best with the best during the expiration and increases with the hand grip. And chest exam bilaterally present and normal vascular pressure for abdomen soft and no organomegaly and no focal neurological deficits is seen and probable diagnosis traumatic heart disease with severe mitral stenosis with moderate aortic stenosis and mild aortic regurgitation with severe pulmonary venous hypertension and severe pulmonary artery hypertension of NVHA functional class 2 in sinus rhythm with paroxysmal atrial fibrillation without CCF at present and without infective endocarditis and no active rheumatic activity.
Finish.
I finished.
Okay. What is the problem in this case? No, there's no problem. Fine, sir. You can explain very well. All fine. Thanks. And here.
Yes, sir. Because of the MS, the symptoms of the aortic stenosis are masked, sir.
Why? How matters is masking aortic stenosis? What are the symptoms
of aortic stenosis? Because of the... With aortic stenosis, there is syncope and angina and dyspnea, sir.
Oh, yeah, I got dyspnea.
Dyspnea, but
not because of
angina is masked, sir, because no, not. Dizziness because of the mitral stenosis, sir, because it is very long duration, sir. Maybe sir, aggravated component because of the aortic stenosis may be present, sir. But purely not because of the aortic stenosis, sir. Aggravated by the by aortic stenosis, sir. But angina is not there because there is no left ventricular hypertrophy because of the low output state because of the mitral stenosis, sir.
Why? Left
ventricular
hypertrophy is absent because of mitral stenosis?
Because mitral stenosis, left ventricular end-diastolic volume will be less, sir. That leads to the reduced hypertrophy, sir. Low output state, sir, because of the low output state.
Moderate
aortic stenosis.
Yes, sir.
Moderate
aortic stenosis. Why? On what basis moderate aortic stenosis? Why do you say moderate aortic stenosis? Because if you say moderate aortic stenosis, I cannot do PTMC here.
Yes, sir.
If mild aortic stenosis, you can take for BME or PTMC.
Yes.
On what basis you told moderate aortic stenosis? You didn't get every type of apex.
Yes, sir. You are the type murmur of the murmurity here of the aortic systolic murmur late beginning duration, sir. And the S2 it also appeared to be narrow. These two features, sir. Suspecting of the moderate aortic regurgitation.
Yes, sir. I think in the presence of mitral stenosis late beginning murmur. So, how does stenosis look now? In spite of mitral stenosis, they are getting late picking yes. more. It's severe aortic stenosis.
Yes.
And okay, fine.
Actually, genetically not possible to identify the severe aortic stenosis with the mitral stenosis because of the low output state. Maybe severe aortic stenosis.
How to decide then? Clinically, you can't decide. You have to take other help, other things, you know, help.
Yes,
or?
Yes, sir.
What, you got suppressional pulses also?
You got suppressional pulses, maybe because of the aortic regurgitation, but it is of only mild intensity, sir. Maybe because of the post-aortic dilatation because of the severe aortic stenosis, that may lead to the post-aortic dilatation.
Post-aortic will get any suppressional pulse, suppressional area, arch. Suppressional pulse, suppressional area will get arch, no. Post-aortic dilatation or not, after an arch. Post-aortic dilatation, you won't see in arch.
Okay.
If you see in suppressional pulses, and you won't get post-aortic dilatation in the outer any rheumatic. Mostly, the congenital
figure. Okay, sir.
And you won't get suppression of pulsation. You felt and you're also able to see. Mention there. You yes, pulsation and you told that suppression of pulsation there. And yes, an inspection also, you described So past internal pulses in there. So in basic severe MS, mild to moderate AS, how to explain the suprasternal pulses in these things here?
Maybe I am underestimated the aortic regurgitation, sir. That may lead to the, because of the low output state, because of the MS.
No, but why do if you underestimate or estimate optimally, it has got, and why there is suprasternal pulses? You mean you are severe, AR is severe here, moderate severe, moderate?
Maybe moderate, sir.
I am talking, both are not good, either you have to talk so one of you listen, so you then you told EDM is very short EDM,
yes.
So other things, no, short EDM there, and BP is 100/70,
yes sir.
You mentioned that there is no outer runoff.
Yes, sir.
You get the no outer runoff not there.
Yes, sir.
So suppressional person because of the jugular veins, or it is, or it is what? Suppressional person means what do you want? What do you think? Suppressional person. What faster anatomy there? What is the anatomy there to give you the suppressional pulsation? What are the points of suppressional pulses? Tell me.
Actually, I don't know, sir.
You should know
dilated
that this is
dilated aortic arch. Dilated aortic arch that is leading to the suppressional pulse.
Yeah, the tell conditions.
Dilated aortic arch with chronic aortic regurgitation, sir.
Then why are you not telling? Severe, chronic
aortic regurgitation. And patent ductus arteriosus, high output states like a, yes. In this condition, we get suppressional pulses.
Coarctation
of aorta also, there will be suppressional pulses, sir. I will get, sir.
We will get an aortic aneurysm, ascending arch aneurysm?
Yes, sir. Ascending aortic aneurysm also possible. It will lead to suppressional pulses.
What do you think, out of this word, you are thinking of aortic irrigation here. So aortic irrigation, very mild aortic irrigation, severe MS, LV type of apex, not, which is not seen at all. There are no clinical signs of left ventricular hypertrophy here, all RV, you told.
Yes,
the person, I don't know, if there are not, if there are what they explain, how do you explain this?
Okay,
and it was moderate is told because of late picking murmur.
Yes, sir.
Murmur picking late of this late system, eh? So LV is,
yes,
systolic prolonged now.
Yes.
Okay. You got grade two or 2/3 partial lift. Second stand closes PP too loud. And A2 is opening stem narrow. You may got it.
It was wide, sir.
Oh, wide, yeah? Oh, wide. Why wide?
Because of the aortic stenosis, it will be increased, sir, comparatively.
Why na? Why?
There will be increased the end diastolic pressure, sir.
Why?
That leads to the.
Why? There is end diastolic blood not coming to left ventricle much, no?
But because of the concentric hypertrophy in the aortic stenosis, there will be increased.
That is theory. It is clinical practical exam. That is all theory. You are telling title matter stenosis. The endastolic gradient is increased because you are getting fistula abscessation. And where is endastolic? LV endastolic is not good. And endastolic LV not filling in endastol because of atestonosis. How can you expect that LVD be higher? That we are getting RV type of apex. No, so many things are there. No, so why the A2 opening stop is here for long year? You don't have any evidence of left ventricular hypertrophy here.
Yes.
Okay, so what do you think matters to Mahal is pliable, not pliable? Not pliable.
There is S1 is loud and opening snap is present. It suggests of the pliable mitral valve, sir.
Suppose somebody's index base is raised in mitral stenosis. What happened to S1?
S1 will be soft, sir, comparatively soft.
Okay.
With increase in the end diastolic pressure, the mitral valve leaflets are already approximate to the closing position, sir, because of the lesser excursion length, the S1 will appears to be soft, sir.
So only loud, yeah? Only loud. But you are getting S1 loud, you are getting S1 loud, and the wrist opening snap, S1 opening snap prolonged. Interval, so when they're getting okay, so how is normal LV industrial pressure?
Normal LV industrial pressure is 10 mmHg, sir.
Okay. Fine. Which condition? There is a condition hypertrophy LV and pressure not raised. Which condition? What are the conditions?
LV hypertrophy and end-diastolic
not raised. I don't know. I asked that question. Just spontaneously came to my mind. I'm asking you. Without thinking, I asked the question to you.
I don't know, sir.
You don't know. Patient has got severe aortic stenosis, atrial fibrillation develop. What will happen?
Severe aortic stenosis with atrial fibrillation. And the diastolic pressure will increase because of the rapid rate. And the diastolic pressure will
I have got capacity to decrease the rate. Heart rate is 80, and aortic stenosis is constantly elevated and artificial level.
Then maybe because of the loss of the atrial kick, there may be less end diastolic pressure, left ventricular end diastolic, less comparatively.
Less, may not be this?
May not be this, sir.
How much atrium contribute to our cardiac output, yeah?
20%, sir. 20%, sir.
Okay, so when a patient develop paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, in this case, particular case?
Yes, sir.
What is happening to the patient that time? No, only complaint, I have got palpitation only. Anything happening to patient symptom-wise in this case?
There is palpitations and aggravation of the, if they are persisting for long duration, there is aggravation of the dyspnea, sir.
This case, yeah, you didn't ask them, you didn't mention that. You didn't mention only 12 palpitation only. And 12 palpitation without any, towards something. There is any loss of consciousness during that time?
So there is no loss of consciousness, sir.
Any aggravation of syndrome that time? That you didn't ask about. Didn't mention the history also.
Actually, I mentioned dyspnea aggravated because of the palpitations. These episodes are associated with the palpitations. So the episodic dyspnea are associated with the episodic palpitations.
Why?
Class 4 episodic dyspnea.
Why? Tell me now, why is happening like this?
Because of the atrial fibrillation and rapid ventricular rate, diastolic filling period is compromised, sir. So because of the diastolic filling compromise, there is an increased gradient, sir, back across the mitral valve. That leads to the backward pressure and that leads to the pulmonary.
So patient develop class 4 breathlessness that time.
Okay, yes, sir.
Okay. Attribution and syncope, what are the procedures?
Atrial fibrillation with syncope, if associated aortic stenosis associated with atrial fibrillation, then he may have syncope, sir. And if atrial fibrillation associated causing the left atrial ball wall thrombus, that causing the obstruction of the mitral inflow tract, that may lead to the syncope, sir. And atrial fibrillation embolizing to the central nervous system also cause syncope, sir. And massive pulmonary embolism also may cause right side pulmonary embolism also cause because of the atrial fibrillation cause syncopes. Yes, sir. Atrial fibrillation associated with the anti-orthotromic conducting accessory pathway that may lead to the rapid ventricular rates.
Orthotromic. What is orthotromic? What is orthotromic?
Antidromic, sir.
What is antidromic? What is orthotromic?
Orthotromic is natural connection with the AV node, sir. Antidromic is connection with accessory pathway, sir. Sorry, sir. Antidromic. Connection with accessory pathway.
Okay. Fine. So, you, only thing that these things you told, no? Moderate is moderator, you want suppressional pulsation. So, these are all, you can't explain it, okay?
Yes, sir. Suppressional pulsation, I can't explain, sir.
Okay, so what is ECG?
Mitral wall pliable, non-pliable? Mitral wall pliable, sir.
Okay. So, what is the problem with this case? As for management concerns, what should you keep in mind this case? Is your mind either it is single wall or double wall procedure?
Yes, aortic stenosis is moderate. I can't do PTMC, sir, because of the sudden increase of the backward pressure that leads to the pulmonary edema, sir. So I have to first assess the severity of the aortic stenosis correctly, sir.
Backward pressure? What backward pressure? Mattress open, mattress blood will go anticoagulated or will go backward?
If AVR is not.
Horrible, you are. You just see if the aortic wall is the you told moderate AC there, and after PTMC, backward pressure, what backward flow? Don't go to backward, no? Blood goes always articulately.
Yes, sir.
New patient develop MR.
Nice patient
develop. MR, you have severe pulmonary edema. Associated with it, but in terms of aortic wall, patient develop severe PBH, pulmonary edema. That is the only condition.
Okay, sir.
Otherwise, open the battle wall, practice won't develop LV dysfunction unless LV is very critical aortic stenosis.
Okay, sir.
Patient has very severe aortic stenosis. When you have to assess the aortic wall, your important thing is, most important thing is assessment of aortic wall here.
Yes, sir.
You have to keep in mind how to see the metal wall suitable for balloon. If aortic wall is not very severely affected, I can do metal wall first. So we can postpone the procedure for a few years. So most important thing, assess the aortic wall disease here.
Yes, sir.
Because as per your findings, in the presence of aortic wall disease, you are getting RV type of apex.
Yes.
That means the mattress is very severe and aortic wall disease not significant here on clinical evaluation. So you have to confirm it. How to confirm it? How do you confirm?
It is because there is a low output condition. dimension, let's say, IoT
work.
Dimensionless index and indexed mitral valve area. These two things are not altered by the load states. Mitral valve area compared to the body surface area and dimensionless index. That is LVOT velocity divided by the aortic wall velocity. If it is less than 0.25, that indicates the severe aortic stenosis.
Okay, fine. Let us go to ECG X-ray
then. Sir, actually, I have not this patient ECG and X-ray, sir. I have collected some mitral stenosis ECG and X-ray, sir. If you
need this. Further, echo finding,
I parked, but it is a severe MS and severe aortic stenosis, sir. I remember the findings, sir. Severe MS and severe aortic stenosis with the aortic regurgitation only mild, sir.
I don't know,
what is the definition of severe AS in the presence of severe AS? Severe
MS. If the aortic valve area is less than... Dimensionless
index and indexed aortic valve area less than 0.6 centimeter square per meter square. It is the law of conservation of mass, sir. Based on that principle, flow across the valve is two valves is the same, sir. If we know velocity time integral and the cross-sectional area of the one valve, we can get the cross-sectional area of the other valve by dividing the...
Whatever amount will enter in the heart, same amount will leave the exit heart.
Yes, sir.
That is the principle. Whatever cardiac output would come to left ventricle, same amount will leave exit through aortic valve.
Yes, sir.
So you know that how much is coming, and same amount will go out.
Yes, sir.
So by that way, you can do the equation that you can know the aortic valve area. So you have to index. Provided the patient has got no significant aortic incompetence.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay. So what to do for this case?
I will plan for aortic wall replacement plus the open metal commissurotomy because of the valve is pliable.
Okay, so now this patient 23 man, what problem you can come across? Surgeon will come back as matter is not here. Get ventricle small. Are you get severe? So what the problem? What the problem? Is the doubting of your cardio surgeon face. So your is outing unnecessary small.
Yes.
So for AV replacement you have to enlarge outing root.
Okay, sir.
That is one problem patient number has. Yeah, case. So you have to implant the adequate size of optimal size of valve here. So patient may develop mismatch. So patient prostate mismatch or prostate person mismatch. That is one issue here.
Okay, sir.
That is one issue. Okay, fine.
Thank you, sir.
How much give INR? Suppose we have AVR plus OMC. How much INR we maintain?
With the AVR, with new two to INR of 2 to 3, sir. If there are no other risk factors are present, sir, like atrial fibrillation or MTL. Yeah, here there is a paroxysmal atrial fibrillation is there. I want to maintain 2.5 to 3.5.
What else
you
do?
Atrial
anything do or just? Is there atrial fibrillation there? Do anything in surgery for atrial fibrillation?
During the surgery, major procedure can be done, sir. Pulmonary vein isolation for the atrial fibrillation. As we are already doing opening the intracardiac repair, same sitting major procedure also possible.
You have to think that because paroxysmal atrial fibrillation there. So we can surgical ablation, surgical pulmonary vein isolation can do.
Yes.
Or you can take, you have done few cases in our institute. So we have done that with the, you know, radio frequency, what is that? What catheter they use, some probe. Radio frequency probe, they are, we have isolated pulmonary veins. We have done surgical ablation, I did done it. Radio frequency, means done MBR with the done few cases done. Okay, fine. Okay, guys. Tomorrow, next day.